Good evening. My name is David Van Cleve, and I'm the president of the Harvard Law School Forum. Tonight, we're pleased to hold our semi-annual Rappaport Lecture, possible with the generosity of Harvard Law School graduate Jerome Rappaport from the class of 1949. Tonight's speaker is Ambassador Alejandro Serrano Caldera, the distinguished ambassador to the United Nations from Nicaragua, and formerly the president of the Nicaraguan Supreme Court. Ambassador Serrano will be introduced in a moment by Harvard Law School lecturer James Rawls. To introduce Ambassador Serrano, we are pleased to have with us Harvard Law School lecturer James Rawls. Professor Rawls teaches the seminar on law, human rights, and the struggle for democracy in Latin America, and is the Associate Director for International Programs at the Harvard Law School Center for Criminal Justice, where he is a primary participant in the Guatemala-Harvard Criminal Justice Project in collaboration with the Guatemalan judiciary. A prolific writer, Professor Rawls has written books on the recent world court proceedings involving the United States and Nicaragua, on law and agrarian reform in Costa Rica, and on the 1969 conflict between El Salvador and Honduras. Professor Rawls is formerly a senior human rights specialist at the Inter-American Commission on Human Rights, and he has been a visiting professor at the University of Costa Rica. I am pleased to introduce Jim Rawls.
Thank you. Before I introduce our speaker tonight, I'd like to say a few words about the guidelines on conduct for student-sponsored events such as that tonight. I have been given the role of moderator, and I want to say just a few words in that capacity before I introduce our speaker and tell you about him. As most of you know, these guidelines were adopted this fall and are designed to ensure a free flow of ideas between all points of view. Harvard Law School and Harvard University are institutions founded on the idea of the free exchange of ideas, and these guidelines are simply aimed to ensure that that free flow takes place. I'm sure that we will ask questions, answer, display disagreement if that should arise, in a forum that is appropriate for this type of intellectual discourse. It's my responsibility to make sure this takes place, and I would like to ask you for your cooperation. Now, I would like to introduce our distinguished speaker tonight. Ambassador Alejandro Serrano Caldera has had a distinguished academic and diplomatic career. He received his doctorate from the National Autonomous University of Nicaragua and also did postdoctoral work in labor law at the University of Rome. He's held a number of positions inside and outside of his country. In Nicaragua, he has been professor of the philosophy of law at the law faculty of the National Autonomous University of Nicaragua from 1965 to 74, and he was secretary general of the university from 1968 to 74, a position equal to that of vice rector. He has been regional advisor for Latin America for the International Labor Organization from 1974 to 79. From 1979 to 1985, he was ambassador of Nicaragua to France and also held other diplomatic posts in Europe. We've just come from dinner, and his French is just as you would expect a former ambassador to France to speak. From May 1985 until April of this year, Ambassador Serrano was president of the Supreme Court of Nicaragua. During his very busy career, he has also been a very active writer and has published numerous books and articles in Spanish, in French, and in Italian, including a treatise on labor law in Spanish and a book on law and Sandinismo in French. He's also published a book of essays entitled Judicial Transformation in Nicaragua. Ambassador Serrano speaks Spanish, French, and Italian fluently. Tonight he will speak in Spanish with the assistance of an interpreter. I give you our distinguished guest this evening, Ambassador Serrano.
My dear friends, I must ask you to please excuse me and allow me to give my exposition in Spanish. Unfortunately, my English is not good enough yet. Next year, I hope, I can address you in your own beautiful language. Thank you for your understanding. Thank you very much. Hablaremos esta noche sobre el desarrollo jurídico institucional de Nicaragua dentro del proceso revolucionario.
Tonight I shall speak about the institutional and judicial development of Nicaragua within the revolutionary process.
En primer lugar, haremos una descripción muy general del mismo para centrarnos luego en la constitución política y más específicamente en el capítulo concerniente al Poder Judicial.
In the first place, I shall give a general description of the process and then focus on the political constitution and move more specifically towards a chapter concerning the judiciary.
Aunque el tema es amplio y complejo, pues toca cuestiones no solo jurídicas, sino también políticas, trataremos de ser lo más breve y preciso que nos sea posible para dejar el tiempo suficiente al periodo de preguntas y respuestas.
Although this is a broad and complex subject, as it touches not only on legal questions, but also on political issues, I shall try to be as brief and precise as possible to leave enough time for questions and answers.
De entrada podemos afirmar que el gobierno de Nicaragua se ha empeñado desde el comienzo de la revolución en establecer el sistema jurídico e institucional que garantice plenamente el ejercicio de los derechos humanos fundamentales.
I can state from the outset that the Nicaraguan government, from the beginning of the revolution, has made efforts to establish a legal and institutional system that fully guarantees the exercise of fundamental human rights.
La institucionalidad de la revolución, que adquiere su base más sólida en la constitución política, es la síntesis de un proceso jurídico que se inicia y desarrolla en medio de limitaciones y de grandes dificultades. Este proceso de integración jurídico-institucional trata de readecuar el universo del derecho y de las instituciones a las transformaciones profundas que ha experimentado la sociedad nicaragüense.
The institutionalization of the revolution, which acquired a more solid basis with the political constitution, synthesized a judicial process that was born and then developed in the midst of limitations and great difficulties. This process of integrating the judiciary and institutions has attempted to adapt the universe of the law and institutions to the profound changes that have been experienced by Nicaraguan society.
Este desarrollo institucional se produce a través de tres etapas. La primera, que arranca del Estatuto Fundamental y del Estatuto de Derechos y Garantías de los Nicaragüenses y que la componen además la Ley de Partidos Políticos, la Ley Creadora del Consejo de Estado, la Ley Electoral y las elecciones presidenciales y legislativas de 1984.
This institutional development took place in three stages. The first emerged from the fundamental law and from the Nicaraguans' Statute of Rights and Guarantees, made up together with the law of political parties by the law that created the State Council, the electoral law and the elections for president and legislators of 1984.
La segunda etapa está conformada por el proceso de elaboración, discusión, aprobación y promulgación de la Constitución, incluyendo los cabildos abiertos, mediante los cuales se sometieron a consulta popular los proyectos de Constitución.
During the second stage, the Constitution was developed, discussed, approved and put into force, and included the open town council meetings through which the drafts of the Constitution were submitted for public consideration.
Finalmente, la tercera etapa en la que estamos actualmente, la forma el proceso de reordenamiento jurídico al texto constitucional. Eso ha llevado un trabajo histórico de la Asamblea Nacional, pero también un trabajo muy importante de otras instituciones como la Corte Suprema de Justicia y el Consejo Supremo Electoral, por ejemplo, en la preparación de proyectos de códigos y de leyes en los campos de su competencia, orientados a la transformación jurídica del país y del aparato judicial nicaragüense.
Finally, we are now in the third stage, composed of the process of legal reorganization to comply with the text of the Constitution. This has involved the historic efforts of the National Assembly and also the very important work of other institutions, such as the Supreme Court and the Supreme Electoral Council, such as, for example, to prepare drafts of codes and laws in their areas of concern, directed towards the transformation of the country's legal and judicial structures.
Cabría hacer una muy rápida mención de las principales leyes que ha aprobado la Asamblea en esta tercera etapa de la vida institucional del país, orientada a la verificación del proceso de readecuación jurídica e institucional a la Constitución política.
I should briefly mention the main laws approved by the National Assembly during this third stage of the country's institutional existence, focused towards the verification of the process of adapting the legal and judicial institutions to the political constitution.
La ley de autonomía aprobada por la Asamblea Nacional y cuyo proyecto fue preparado por una comisión especial reglamenta el tratamiento que da la constitución política a nuestras comunidades étnicas de la costa atlántica y reconoce su identidad cultural, étnica y lingüística. Reglamenta sus formas de organización política, social y jurídica y reafirma sus derechos históricos sobre la tierra, confirmando de esta forma y avanzando más allá los derechos consagrados en el artículo 26 del Pacto de los Derechos Civiles y Políticos de la Organización de Naciones Unidas.
The law of autonomy approved by the National Assembly, which was drafted by a special commission, provides rules for the political constitution's treatment of our ethnic communities on the Atlantic coast. It recognizes their cultural, ethnic, and linguistic identity. It provides rules for their forms of political, social, and legal organization. It reasserts their historic rights over the land, thus confirming and expanding the rights codified in Article 26 of the Treaty on Civil and Political Rights of the United Nations Organization.
La filosofía que anima esta ley ha avanzado incluso más que los instrumentos jurídicos internacionales, pues en ella se superan los conceptos de integración o de incorporación que de alguna manera implican su asimilación a la unidad nacional dominante, para reafirmar más bien el carácter complementario y de retroalimentación de las diferentes etnias y culturas que conforman la nación nicaragüense, diseñando de esta manera un nuevo concepto de Estado-Nación, multiétnico y multilingüe, cuyos objetivos están orientados a reproducir justamente los valores de estas entidades múltiples de nuestra historia.
The spirit guiding this law has advanced beyond international legal instruments, because it surpasses the concepts of integration or incorporation, which in some way imply assimilation with the main national identity. Instead, this law reasserts the complementary nature and the feedback existing among the various ethnic and cultural groups that make up the Nicaraguan nation. Thus, the law has designed a new concept of a multi-ethnic, multilingual nation-state, with goals directed towards reproducing fairly values of this of these various entities in our history.
Creo importante mencionar que esta ley fue fruto de un diálogo con los propios representantes de estas comunidades, misquitos, sumos, creoles, ramas y garífonos.
I think it is important to mention that this law was the product of a dialogue with the representatives of these communities themselves, miskitos, sumos, creoles, ramas and garífonos.
La nueva ley de amparo, aprobada en días pasados, que consagra tres recursos extraordinarios, el habeas corpus, mediante el cual y a través de la exhibición personal se garantiza la integridad física, psíquica y moral de la persona. El recurso de amparo propiamente dicho contra los actos del Ejecutivo y de la Administración Pública en detrimento de las garantías y derechos de la persona protegidos por la Constitución.
The new law of amparo or sanctuary that was recently approved gives authority to three special appeals: habeas corpus, which guarantees by displaying the person his or her physical, psychological and moral integrity. The appeal for sanctuary is an appeal against actions of the executive or public administration that might harm a person's rights and guarantees, which are protected by the Constitution.
Finalmente, el recurso de inconstitucionalidad de la ley, el que puede interponerse ante la Corte Suprema de Justicia contra cualquier ley, decreto o reglamento proveniente aún de la propia Asamblea Nacional en el caso de que la ley vulnere algún precepto de la Constitución política. En todos los casos, la sentencia de la Corte Suprema tiene efectos derogatorios sobre la ley, decreto o reglamento.
Finally, the appeal against the law's unconstitutionality. This can be filed before the Supreme Court against any law, decree or rule, even when it originates in the National Assembly. It can be filed if a law injures a precept of the political constitution. In every case, the ruling of the Supreme Court can annul the law, decree or rule.
Cabe también destacar, aunque solo sea por la simple mención de ellas, la nueva ley electoral y la ley de municipalidades aprobadas recientemente, las que regularán todo lo concerniente a la elección de autoridades supremas del país, presidente y vicepresidente de la República y Asamblea Nacional, y lo que atañe a la atención y a la elección y organización municipales respectivamente.
I should also mention, even if it's just in passing, the new electoral law and the municipal law, which were recently approved. They govern matters concerning the election of the country's main authorities, the President and the Vice President of the Republic and the National Assembly, and matters concerning the election and organization of municipalities.
Al triunfo de la revolución se produjo, entre otras cosas, una ruptura entre las profundas transformaciones sociales y el sistema jurídico institucional, particularmente el sistema judicial.
After the triumph of the revolution, there was, among other things, a break between the profound social changes and the legal institutional system, especially with the judiciary.
La decisión adoptada frente a la fractura de esos dos universos fue la de derogar la Constitución Política de 1974, proteger las garantías y derechos fundamentales y las líneas básicas de organización del Estado en el Estatuto de Derechos y Garantías de los Nicaragüenses y en el Estatuto Fundamental.
Faced with the breach between these two worlds, the decision was to annul the political constitution of 1974, to protect basic guarantees and rights, and to protect the basic guidelines of the state's organization through the law of rights and guarantees of Nicaraguans and the fundamental law.
Por otro lado, se mantuvo en general lo que podríamos llamar el sistema jurídico ordinario, códigos, leyes. Se redujo la jurisdicción del poder judicial, pero en lo general se mantuvo su concepción y estructura.
On the other hand, we maintained what we could call the ordinary system of justice. That is, codes and laws. The jurisdiction of the judiciary was reduced, but its overall conception and structure were maintained.
Al lado de esto, se emitieron numerosos decretos y se crearon las jurisdicciones especiales en razón de la naturaleza especialmente sensible de la actividad y a las serias limitaciones estructurales y funcionales de un nuevo poder judicial que comenzaba a organizarse.
At the same time, many decrees were published, creating special jurisdictions. This was due to the especially sensitive nature of our activities and to severe structural and functional limitations of our newly evolving judiciary, which was just beginning to get organized.
Se creó la jurisdicción especial para el juzgamiento de los detenidos de la antigua Guardia de Somoza y se crearon además jurisdicciones en materia de inquilinato, de guarda y tutela de los menores y el Tribunal Agrario.
A special jurisdiction was created for the trials of prisoners who had formerly been Somoza's guards, and we also created jurisdictions dealing with tenancy, the protection and guardianship of minors, and the agrarian court.
Esta etapa fue caracterizada por la importancia de estas jurisdicciones especiales, por la preponderancia del Ministerio de Justicia y por el esfuerzo de los tribunales y la Corte Suprema por darle coherencia al sistema a través de la jurisprudencia.
This stage was characterized by the importance of these jurisdictions, by the overriding importance of the Ministry of Justice, and by the efforts of the courts and the Supreme Court to try and make the system coherent through case law.
A partir de 1985 y con miras a la Constitución Política, la Corte Suprema comienza a diseñar su propuesta sobre el Poder Judicial, la que está contenida en el capítulo y título octavo de nuestra Constitución, promulgada en enero de 1987.
As from 1985, and bearing in mind that there was a future political constitution, the Supreme Court began the draft concerning the judiciary. This is contained in Chapter 5, Title 8 of our Constitution, which was put into effect in January of 1987.
Ahí se consagraron principios clásicos, pero que convenía reafirmarlos en el texto constitucional, tales como la independencia del Poder Judicial y la obligatoriedad inexcusable de las decisiones judiciales.
Classic principles were defined there, but it was important to reassert these within the text of the Constitution. Principles such as the independence of the judiciary and the adamantly obligatory nature of legal decisions.
También se consagró el principio de la unidad de la jurisdicción, lo que obligaba a una reestructuración del sistema judicial sobre la base de la reunificación de la jurisdicción en el propio Poder Judicial.
The principle of jurisdictional unity was also defined. This led to a restructuring of the judiciary based on the reunification of jurisdictions within the judiciary.
A la vez, el artículo 164 de la Constitución estableció las facultades de la Corte Suprema para organizar y dirigir el Poder Judicial.
At the same time, Article 164 of the Constitution established the Supreme Court's authority for organizing and directing the judiciary.
Como hecho notable y ya enlazado con los acuerdos de Esquipulas III, reunión de los presidentes centroamericanos en Alajuela, Costa Rica, habría que mencionar la abolición de los tribunales populares antisomocistas y el traspaso de su jurisdicción al Poder Judicial. También, posteriormente, el traspaso de la jurisdicción de los comités regionales de asuntos habitacionales a los tribunales ordinarios y, consecuentemente, el traspaso del recurso de apelación en los juicios de inquilinatos, antes en conocimiento y decisión del ministro de la Vivienda, a manos de los tribunales de apelación del sistema judicial.
A notable event which was linked to the agreements of Esquipulas III, this was a meeting of the Central American presidents in Alajuela, Costa Rica, we should mention the abolition of the popular anti-Somoza tribunals and the transfer of their jurisdiction to the judiciary. Later, the jurisdiction of the regional committees for housing affairs was transferred to the ordinary courts. As a consequence, the appeals in cases involving tenants, which previously were investigated and decided by the Ministry of Housing, were transferred to the courts of appeal within the judiciary.
Merece también mencionarse dentro de las realizaciones concretas de lo establecido en la Constitución, la reglamentación del artículo 164, inciso 1 de la Constitución, por medio de los decretos 299 y 303, que dan a la Corte Suprema la facultad de creación, supresión y fusión de juzgados, organización de tribunales de apelación y establecimiento de competencia de los jueces por razón de la materia y la cuantía, sobre la base de acuerdos de la propia Corte Suprema de Justicia y sin necesidad de enviar para cada caso proyectos de ley a la Asamblea Nacional.
I should also mention among these concrete achievements what has been established in the Constitution the rules applying to Article 164, paragraph 1 of the Constitution, through decrees 299 and 303. These give the court authority to create, suppress, or combine courts, to organize courts of appeal, and establish the legal authority of judges according to subject and importance, based on agreements with the Supreme Court, without having to send, in each case, a draft to the National Assembly.
Es cuestión también muy importante la participación de la Corte Suprema en la preparación de proyectos de códigos y de leyes en los asuntos de su competencia.
It's very important to mention also the participation of the Supreme Court in the preparation of drafts of codes and laws in affairs within its authority.
Aquí mencionaremos de manera breve la elaboración del proyecto de ley de reforma procesal penal que derogó el decreto 1130 y que fue preparado por la Corte junto con el Ministerio de Justicia y el Ministerio del Interior.
I should briefly mention the development of the draft for a law to reform criminal procedural law, annulling Decree 1130, and which was prepared by the Court together with the Ministry of Justice and the Ministry of Interior.
La Asamblea ya aprobó estas reformas, cuya parte más importante es la abolición del monopolio de la acción penal, quedando su exclusividad en manos de la Procuraduría únicamente para delitos contra la seguridad de la nación, delitos económicos y asesinato atroz.
The Assembly has already given its approval to these reforms. Perhaps the most important part is the derogation of a monopoly in penal activity. The monopoly is maintained only in the hands of the public prosecutor for crimes against national security, for economic crimes, and for grievous murder.
En este contexto habría que mencionar la disolución del Ministerio de Justicia, hecho este que junto a las atribuciones constitucionales y reglamentarias a la Corte Suprema, demuestra que la preponderancia en el sistema judicial, antes en manos del Ministerio de Justicia, ha pasado ahora al Poder Judicial.
In this context, I should mention the dissolution of the Ministry of Justice. This fact, which together with the constitutional powers and legal powers of the Supreme Court, shows that the main role within the judiciary, which was previously in the hands of the Ministry of Justice, has now been transferred to the judiciary.
Para concluir, habría que recordar que junto a todas estas atribuciones notables que por disposición constitucional y reglamentaria ha adquirido la Corte Suprema de Justicia, se encuentra también el constitucional que ejerce la Corte mediante el recurso de inconstitucionalidad de la ley y del cual hemos hablado brevemente con anterioridad.
To conclude, we must remember that together with these important powers acquired through constitutional and legal means by the Supreme Court, we must include the constitutional power exercised by the Court through the appeal of unconstitutionality of the law, which I referred to briefly earlier.
En esta breve y apretada exposición, hemos querido presentar las grandes líneas de la política jurídica y judicial nicaragüenses. Hemos querido explicarle no tanto los detalles técnicos como la lógica de estas transformaciones, las que se producen con grandes esfuerzos en medio de una guerra de agresión que dura ya 7 años.
In this brief and concise talk, I have wanted to present the overall guidelines of legal and judicial policy in Nicaragua. I have wanted to explain not merely the technical details, but rather the logic behind these changes, produced through great efforts in the middle of an aggressive war that's been going on now for 7 years.
Con todas sus limitaciones e imperfecciones, Nicaragua presenta ya a estas alturas el diseño de un sistema jurídico avanzado y coherente, en el que destacan recursos legales ordinarios y extraordinarios de protección de la persona humana y de las garantías individuales y colectivas.
Despite all of its limitations and imperfections, Nicaragua by now presents the design of an advanced and coherent legal system, showing ordinary and extraordinary legal means for protecting individual persons and providing individual and collective guarantees.
Recursos de apelación, casación, habeas corpus, amparo e inconstitucionalidad de la ley garantizan la seguridad jurídica y las garantías individuales del pueblo nicaragüense.
The rights to appeal, the right of cassation, habeas corpus, right of sanctuary and unconstitutionality of the law, guarantee legal security and individual rights for the Nicaraguan people.
A su vez, todo su sistema legal de protección a los derechos humanos está esparcido en nuestra legislación y fortalecido por el artículo 46 de la Constitución nicaragüense. En efecto, este artículo incorpora a rango constitucional los 5 instrumentos internacionales más importantes, a saber, la Declaración Universal de los Derechos Humanos, el Pacto Internacional de los Derechos Civiles y Políticos de la ONU, el Pacto Internacional de los Derechos Económicos, Sociales y Culturales de la misma ONU y la Convención Americana de Derechos Humanos.
At the same time, the entire system of protecting human rights is scattered throughout our law and bolstered by Article 46 of the Nicaraguan Constitution. In effect, this article raises to a constitutional level the 5 most important international instruments, to wit, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, the International Agreement of Civil and Political Rights of the United Nations, the International Agreement of Economic, Social and Cultural Rights of the United Nations, and the American Human Rights Convention.
Todo este sistema jurídico deberá irse perfeccionando en la práctica y la experiencia del futuro, el que esperamos sea de paz, para que podamos desarrollar a plenitud nuestras potencialidades creativas y nuestras instituciones.
This entire legal system will be gradually perfected with practice and experience in the future, which we hope will be peaceful, so that we may fully develop our creative potential and our institutions.
Queremos confiar que una nueva administración en los Estados Unidos va a poner fin a la guerra de agresión que padecemos desde hace 7 años y que un período de paz y de convivencia va a abrirse entre nuestros países cuyos pueblos, aunque diferentes, tienen en común valores fundamentales de justicia y de libertad. Muchas gracias.
We would like to trust that a new administration in the United States will bring an end to the war of aggression that we have been enduring for the past 7 years, and that a time of peace and coexistence will blossom between our countries, whose peoples are different, but share common basic values in the area of justice and freedom. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Comandante Serrano, and I'm sorry, I know that you were Chief Justice of Nicaragua, but somehow I can't bring myself to address you as Chief Justice, because there is no justice in the Sandinista dictatorship, as indicated by the plight of Agustin Harkane Anayo, the President of the Social Christian Party. Certainly. The President of the Social Christian Party in Nicaragua, who has been in jail since July 10th of this year after addressing a major rally in one of your cities. Number one, why have they jailed this man and refused to set him free? Number two, why have they refused medical treatment to his companion lawyer, Roger Guevara Mena, who suffers from epilepsy and experiences several attacks a day? Why do his guards toss tear gas into their cells on a regular basis and confine them in small spaces for days and months on end, where the temperature soars above 140 degrees Fahrenheit? Is this indicative of the political reform in the Sandinista dictatorship which you implied earlier? That is my question.
Bueno, en primer lugar, yo quiero hacer una aclaración. No soy, ni he sido, y probablemente no seré comandante.
In the first place, I would like to clarify something. I have never been a commander.
Soy solo un intelectual que quiere dar su aporte modesto pero firme a esta revolución que ha transformado la historia de un pueblo sometido en la historia de un pueblo libre.
I am only an intellectual who has tried to modestly contribute to the evolution of this new system following a revolution following the submission of its peoples in history.
En cuanto a sus preguntas, pero más que preguntas, en cuanto a sus afirmaciones, porque antes de preguntar ha afirmado una serie de cosas.
Before answering your questions, or rather your statements, because you have made statements about a series of things.
Yo quisiera decir en general que el problema al que usted se refiere, que es el caso de Nandaime.
I would like to say in general that the case to which you have referred, which is the case of Nandaime,
es un caso en el cual las personas que fueron detenidas lo fueron porque violentaron la ley en una manifestación.
The people who were arrested were detained because they broke the law in a public manifestation.
Que tenía por objeto formar parte de un plan de desestabilización interno ligado a la guerra externa.
Which had as its purpose a process of destabilization linked to the external war.
A estas personas se puso a la orden de los tribunales de justicia.
These people were turned over to the courts.
Algunas de ellas fueron puestas en libertad por razones de salud.
Some of them were set free for health reasons.
Como es el caso de la doctora Miriam Argüello.
Which is the case of Dr. Miriam Argüello.
Otros fueron sobreseídos definitivamente, liberados definitivamente.
In others, the case was dismissed and they were set free.
Por decisión del juez.
Given the decision of the judge.
Y otros fueron sancionados con un auto de prisión por haberse encontrado violaciones específicas a la ley.
And others were sentenced to time in jail for having violated specific laws.
Yo pienso que cualquier país del mundo tiene el derecho elemental y primario.
I believe that any country in this world has the primary and elementary right
de aplicar las leyes
to apply its laws
cuando el caso lo requiere.
As the case may require.
Y creo que es importante mencionar que en Nicaragua, justamente en un clima en el cual se vive una guerra, que no estoy descubriendo yo aquí esta noche, sino que es una realidad.
And I must say that in Nicaragua, where we live a climate where there's a war going on, I'm not going to describe it here, but this is the truth.
Se han hecho esfuerzos enormes en medio de estas dificultades y limitaciones.
We have made enormous efforts, given these difficulties and limitations,
por consolidar un sistema jurídico.
To try and put together a legal system.
De ese esfuerzo yo he querido hablarles un poco esta noche.
And I have tried to talk about this effort tonight.
Just a brief follow-up. I mean, I certainly understand that any government has the right to apply its laws and to jail those who break them. But surely the sustained imprisonment of major political figures and their physical mistreatment in prison is hardly conducive to the type of open system governed by rule of law, which you claim to want to bring about.
En primer lugar, toda cárcel es dura y ojalá no existieran cárceles si no existieran delitos.
In the first place, any jail is tough, and I wish we didn't have to have jails. We wouldn't need them if there weren't any crimes.
Ojalá jamás ningún gobierno, ni el nuestro, ni el suyo, ni ningún otro en cualquier parte del mundo tuviese que usar de las medidas represivas que la propia ley da para defenderse.
Ideally, no country, my country or your country, would have to use any sort of repressive means in order to defend itself.
Esta gente fue detenida hace unos meses.
These people were arrested some months ago.
Y hay decisiones judiciales sobre su detención.
And the court has already made a determination about their punishment.
Y hay alrededor de 25 personas ya puestas en libertad.
And some 25 people have already been released.
Porque a pesar de haberse encontrado responsabilidades específicas,
because although they had certain specific responsibilities,
se consideraron que eran menores.
We considered that these were minor.
Y fueron exonerados de responsabilidad.
And they were found without responsibility.
Otros, como señalaba, han sido sancionados por la ley.
But others, as I mentioned, have been punished by the law.
Hay que tener en cuenta una circunstancia.
We must bear in mind a set of circumstances.
Que este hecho no se trataba de un ejercicio de la libertad política.
This fact was not an exercise in political freedom,
sino que formaba parte de un plan de desestabilización.
It was part of a plan for destabilization,
cuyo propósito no era expresar su ideología para obtener simpatías populares.
Its purpose was not to express ideology in order to obtain political support,
sino crear un caos interno ligado a una agresión externa.
But rather to create internal chaos linked to external aggression,
que tenía por objeto único el derrocamiento de un gobierno legítimamente constituido,
which has as its sole purpose the overthrow of a legitimate government.
Ojalá algún día podamos nosotros, los nicaragüenses,
I hope that one day we Nicaraguans
vivir en paz.
We'll be able to live in peace.
Esta situación es fruto de una guerra que existe y que no es inventada.
This situation is the product of a war that is real. It's not an invention.
Que ha producido 50,000 muertes,
which has produced 50,000 deaths,
en 7 años,
in 7 years,
en un país de 3 millones de habitantes,
in a country that has 7 million inhabitants,
que sumadas a las 50,000 muertes anteriores durante la Guerra de Liberación,
which if you add these to the 50,000 deaths that took place
suman 100,000 muertos,
during the wars of liberation, this adds up to 100,000 people dead,
en un pueblo de 3 millones de habitantes,
in a country that has only 3 million inhabitants,
y en un lapso de 10 años,
and over a period of 10 years.
Tal vez esta cifra pueden dar la magnitud de la tragedia que enfrenta el pueblo nicaragüense.
Perhaps these figures can illustrate the magnitude of the tragedy faced by the Nicaraguan people,
y de los esfuerzos enormes que se hacen para tratar de estabilizar un sistema jurídico institucional.
And of the enormous efforts that have been carried out in order to create a legal institutional system.
Y por tomar la opción más difícil, que es la opción de hacer elecciones, elaborar una constitución política y producir una reforma jurídica.
The most difficult roles and decisions, which are to create a new constitution, to carry out elections, and to carry out legal transformation.
Desde un punto de vista estricto del poder político,
from a point of view that is strictly political power,
sería más fácil no estar metidos en estos esfuerzos jurídicos.
It would be much easier not to get involved in these legal efforts.
Pero nosotros no queremos eso.
But we don't want that.
Nosotros hemos querido, de alguna manera, ser un ejemplo en un país que cambia.
We have wanted, in a way, to be an example in a country where there is change.
Y nos hemos abocado a labores inmensas.
And we have become devoted to these huge tasks.
Como es hacer al mismo tiempo,
such as, for example, to simultaneously
una reforma institucional,
create institutional reformation,
y defender una guerra,
and defend ourselves in a war,
que se nos ha obligado a pelear,
a war that we have been obliged to fight.
Mr. Ambassador.
Yes, sir, you claim that your country is not a Soviet base, yet today the Sandinista dictatorship is supported by 3,000 Cuban combat troops and 1,000 Soviet military advisors.
Excuse me, could you slow down? You're talking too fast.
Sorry. You have so far? A former member of your junta remarked that Nicaragua is an occupied country where no crucial decision is taken without the approval of the Cubans. How can Nicaragua claim their independence with these outside military forces on the soil?
¿Cómo puede decir usted que Nicaragua es un país libre si recibe ayuda militar de este tipo?
Sí. Me bastaría mencionar la diferencia sin juzgar ni a Cuba ni a la Unión Soviética, pero que son dos países completamente distintos y dos sistemas diferentes.
I just have to say that we're dealing with two completely different countries with two completely different systems.
Son dos revoluciones que responden a dos momentos históricos y a dos idiosincrasias, a dos características de pueblos diferentes.
These are two revolutions that responded to two very different situations and two very different idiosyncrasies of the people themselves.
Brevemente le pongo algunos ejemplos, nada más.
Let me give you a few brief examples.
Esta es una revolución con elecciones presidenciales y legislativas.
Our revolution has involved presidential and legislative elections.
Esta es una revolución con una constitución política dada a los pocos años de haberse realizado.
This is a revolution which has a constitution that was put together very few years after the revolution.
Esta es una revolución con cinco recursos de garantías individuales.
This is a revolution that has five different rights guaranteeing individual rights.
Con 15 partidos políticos.
There are 15 political parties.
Activos, además.
Active political parties.
Con 6 organizaciones sindicales.
And 6 labor organizations.
Activas también.
Which are also active.
Que no son creadas de pantalla por el gobierno.
And which have not been created as a smokescreen by the government.
Vemos su actividad objetiva y concretamente.
We can objectively see the activities of these organizations.
Es una revolución con participación de diferentes ideologías.
This is a revolution in which different ideologies have participated.
Pero finalmente es una revolución con cambios profundos.
But it is, after all, a revolution with very profound changes.
Que no pretende ni ha pretendido jamás ser una nueva Cuba,
which doesn't pretend to be and never has pretended to be another Cuba,
sino solamente ser una nueva Nicaragua.
It only wants to be a new Nicaragua.
Hello, I'm not sure if you're ready for this question. It's not a hostile one. As you may know, the Costa Rican judiciary has stated that they believe the CIA was involved in the assassination attempt on Eden Pastora, a former Sandinista hero who refused to succumb to CIA pressures to join former Nicaraguan death squad generals now running the Contras. Their purpose was to blame the Sandinistas for the bombing and to create an excuse for an invasion. As you may know, 8 people were killed, one, including one American journalist. Do you know if the Nicaraguan government has any evidence related to this case?
No sé si las tenga.
I don't know if it has them or not.
La prueba real es la inocencia del gobierno nicaragüense en esto.
The evidence, the true evidence, is the innocence of the Nicaraguan government in all this.
Y son otros los que han señalado quiénes son los culpables y los responsables.
And others have been pointed to as responsible and guilty parties.
A nosotros habitualmente se nos hace responsable de demasiadas cosas.
We are normally blamed for far too many things.
Se nos atribuye una capacidad de acción mucho mayor que la real.
We are given a capacity for action that is far beyond our true capacity.
Y a veces se nos responsabiliza de males ciertos o posibles.
And sometimes we are blamed for things that are barely possible or cannot be carried out.
Un hecho es claro, nuestra absoluta no participación en estas cuestiones.
There is one central fact, which is our absolute non-participation in this case.
Yo no quiero desde esta tribuna responsabilizar a nadie específicamente.
I don't want to blame anybody here from the podium.
En todo caso, ya lo hizo el propio Pastora.
In any case, Pastora himself already did so.
Y ya lo hicieron otros que no pueden ser sospechosos de simpatía sandinista.
And others have done so also, others who are not suspected of being Sandinista sympathizers.
Nuestro esfuerzo único y efectivo es tratar de consolidar nuestra revolución.
Our only objective effort is to try to consolidate our revolution.
Que se nos deje en paz.
We want to be left alone.
Que nos permitan desarrollar nuestro sistema jurídico político.
We want to be allowed to develop our legal and political system in peace.
Que se detenga la guerra.
We want the war to stop.
Y que se abra un periodo fructífero de reconstrucción de nuestro país.
And we want to evolve towards a fruitful period of reconstruction in our country.
Estamos seguros que
we
si esto ocurre,
sure that if this were to happen,
Nicaragua podrá mostrar al mundo de lo que es capaz también en tiempos de paz.
Nicaragua will be able to show the world what it can do in times of peace.
According to the Nicaraguan Commission of Jurists, the Sandinistas have executed 7,884 people by 1980. Luis Alberto Manje, the former socialist president of Costa Rica, remarked in 1984, "I never thought I would say, as I do now, it would have it worse in 4 years of Sandinistas than in 40 years of Somozas." How can you intimate that your dictatorship has a commitment to human rights in light of these remarks?
Sí. Yo podría eludir la respuesta diciendo quisiera saber quiénes son estas siete personas ejecutadas por el régimen sandinista.
I would be able to evade the question by asking you who these seven people, did you say seven, are who were executed by the Sandinistas.
No, I didn't say so. I said 7,884.
7,000. 7,000. Yo creo que, mire, si se hubiese ejecutado a uno solo, habría sido suficiente para que cierta prensa hiciese un escándalo contra nosotros.
If just one had been executed, that would have been enough for certain elements of the press to make up a tremendous scandal against us.
Se nos ha acusado por otro lado de tener 20,000 guardias somocistas prisioneros.
We have been accused of keeping 20,000 of Somoza's guards in jail.
O una culpa o la otra.
We're either blamed for one thing or we're blamed for the other.
Justamente si en un momento al comienzo de la revolución hubo 20,000 detenidos.
If at the beginning of the revolution we arrested 20,000 people.
Fue porque no hubo ningún ejecutado.
We arrested them because we didn't execute them.
Y es mucho mejor que así haya sido.
And it's much better that this is the way it was.
Esta revolución, antes de que se desatara una campaña terrible de difamación en su contra.
This revolution, before the campaign of defamation began against it,
demostró que se produjo una transformación sustancial en Nicaragua.
Showed that an important transformation took place in Nicaragua.
Sin un solo ejecutado.
Without executing anybody.
El primer acto de la Junta de Gobierno.
The first activity of the Junta in the government.
Fue abolir la pena de muerte.
Was to abolish the death penalty.
Pero comprenderá usted que me veo en la situación de responder una pregunta que es, disculpe, absolutamente desmesurada. Yo había entendido siete, ¿no?
Excuse me, but you put me in a position that I have to respond to a question that is absolutely unreasonable. I had understood seven.
Jamás en Nicaragua han habido ejecuciones.
Executions have never taken place in Nicaragua.
Yo podía haber entendido que algún abuso en una guerra tan tremenda como fue la que vivimos.
I can understand that you might have some sort of abuse in a situation of war that is so terrible and which we're going through.
Pudo haber llevado a situaciones de suprimir la vida alguna persona en medio del momento inicial del caos después del triunfo.
This can lead to loss of life in a situation which is chaotic before you finally triumph.
Pero justamente nuestra política ha sido, y nuestro primer acto fue, la abolición de la pena de muerte.
But our policy has been precisely to abolish the death penalty.
Mr. Ambassador, you may characterize the hostility of this question however you see fit.
Could you speak slowly, please?
Yes. Several weeks ago, Time magazine, normally, which is usually critical of Reagan administration policies toward Nicaragua, conceded that in that quote, in since 1979, the Sandinistas' most salient achievements have been to consolidate their power, build a formidable military machine, and suppress dissent. They also noted that the economy is rapidly disintegrating, with widespread reports of people sifting through piles of garbage simply to obtain food. And this was in Time magazine. So I ask you, in view of the fact that the Democratic Congress, by eradicating the Contra movement, has deprived your regime of its usual source of blame for Nicaragua's deplorable living conditions, will you now admit that your regime has reduced Nicaragua to the status of an international pauper? Freedom of speech for liberals only. And will you now pledge that you will finally conform to the terms of the Arias peace plan? Which you have been violating since its inception.
Perdón, hay algo que no le entendí.
There's something that I didn't understand.
¿Qué?
Bueno, hay preguntas, más que preguntas, las que ustedes son afirmaciones.
You are making statements rather than questions.
Es decir, acusaciones.
Accusations.
Pero yo estoy dispuesto, por supuesto, a dialogar con usted sobre eso y sobre cualquier otra cosa.
But I am very willing to talk with you about this or about anything else.
Para eso he venido aquí.
This is why I have come here.
Pero no le entendí lo del Congreso que dijo que había eliminado al culpable. Si es tan amable y pudiese precisarme esa parte de su exposición.
Because the Democratic Congress has effectively eradicated the Contras as a fighting force, you no longer have them as a source of blame for the inexcusable conditions inside your country. So how do you justify what is occurring there presently?
Sí, ya entiendo.
Yes, I understand.
¿Cuánto hace que eliminó la ayuda?
When was aid stopped?
Permítame hacerle yo a usted algunas preguntas.
Let me ask you some questions too.
En el mismo espíritu democrático en que estamos, ¿verdad?
In the same spirit of freedom of speech that you mentioned.
Yes.
¿Cuánto hace?
We cherish it here. What of course I mean is military aid. The Contras cannot fight Soviet Hind gunships with band-aids and bread loaves. They do receive a trickling of humanitarian aid, that which is able to get through to the camps, that which the Sandinistas don't stop.
Bueno, no me contestó mi pregunta, pero no importa, ¿no?
Well, you didn't answer my question, but that's all right.
No, I think
esto de la ayuda militar son unos pocos meses lo que hace, pero hay 7 años de guerra.
This
constatación.
Question of military aid is a question of a few months, but we've been going through this war for 7 years.
Segunda constatación: Nicaragua es un país que cuando triunfa la revolución encuentra en sus arcas saqueadas por Somoza $3 million.
Nicaragua is a country that at the end of the revolution found in its treasury, sacked by the Somozas, a sum of $3 million
para cubrir las importaciones de dos días.
And this was enough to buy products, to import products for 2 days.
Permítame
contestarle. Sí. Let me answer.
50,000 muertos de una guerra de 3 años.
We had 50,000 deaths following a war of 3 years.
8 ciudades destruidas.
8 cities that were destroyed.
A los 2 años, 3 años del triunfo revolucionario.
And within 2 to 3 years of our revolutionary victory.
7 años de guerra ininterrumpida.
These were followed by 7 years of uninterrupted war.
Mantenida, sabemos por quién.
Maintained, we know by whom.
Un embargo comercial desde 1985.
A commercial embargo dating from 1985.
Un bloqueo virtual para Nicaragua.
A virtual blockade for Nicaragua.
Un bloqueo en los organismos de financiamiento internacional.
A blocking of all our credit in international organizations.
Y un conjunto de medidas que las estoy mencionando con nombre y apellido.
And a number of measures which I shall now proceed to name.
Y un conjunto de hechos que los estoy señalando específicamente.
And a number of facts that I have specifically referred to.
Que han convergido durante 7 años.
Which over a period of 7 years have converged.
8 años o más tiempo todavía.
8 years or even more.
Con un solo propósito.
They converged towards a single purpose.
Destruir la economía de Nicaragua.
To destroy the Nicaraguan economy.
Para derrocar a la revolución.
In order to overthrow the revolution.
¿Te parece que a la hora de hacer una afirmación tan categórica como la suya?
I believe that given your very categorical statement,
se deberían tener en cuenta, al menos como referencia, estos elementos.
You should bear in mind, at least as a point of reference, these elements that I have mentioned.
En este momento nosotros estamos enfrentando, junto a este conjunto de hechos que he mencionado,
at present, we are facing, together with everything else that I have mentioned,
una tragedia producida esta vez por otras fuerzas.
A tragedy brought about this time by other forces.
Por las fuerzas de la naturaleza.
The forces of Mother Nature.
El huracán Joan.
Hurricane John.
Que nos ha dejado pérdida de $1,000 millones.
Has produced a loss of $1 billion.
Es un país que necesita de la ayuda internacional para sobrevivir.
This is a country that requires international assistance in order to survive.
Es un país como pocos que ha soportado una guerra 7 años.
It's a country that is a rare thing. It's tolerated a war for 7 years.
Una guerra que no ha sido un juguete, sino que ha sido una tragedia para todos.
A war that hasn't been a plaything. It's been a tragedy for everybody.
Y jamás se puede invocar ni exigir la democracia dentro de un país que es responsabilidad nuestra. Cuando se le está haciendo la guerra a este país.
And you can never invoke democracy when you are fighting a war against.
Me parece que eso es poco democrático.
I believe that this is not very democratic.
A nosotros se nos pide que soportemos una guerra de varios años.
We are being asked to tolerate a war of many years.
Un bloqueo económico.
An economic blockade.
Un embargo comercial.
A commercial embargo.
Y todavía un huracán. Bueno, que eso nadie tiene responsabilidades, por supuesto.
There's no responsibility for that, of course.
Y todavía que nuestra economía sea floreciente.
And now you are demanding that our economy flourish.
Confiamos que en condiciones. Pedimos un poquito de tolerancia nada más y de comprensión a esta situación.
We ask for just a bit of tolerance and understanding for our situation.
Que se entienda que somos un pueblo que hemos sufrido mucho y que continuamos sufriendo.
We want you to understand that we are a people that has suffered a lot and we continue to suffer.
Que se trate de entender qué es lo que pasa en Nicaragua.
You should try and understand what is happening in Nicaragua.
Que por un momento, aunque sea solo por un momento,
which for a moment, even if it's just a brief moment,
dejemos a un lado,
we should leave to one side
los clichés,
clichés,
las acusaciones
a priori accusations,
los cargos de mala conciencia contra quien sufre y trata de sobrevivir,
various charges of a bad conscience against people who suffer and try to survive.
Y ya no le pido que esté de acuerdo que se nos ayude.
I don't ask that you agree that we should be helped.
Pero por lo menos que se nos comprenda.
But we do ask for understanding.
Por lo menos que se nos critique.
Or at least that we be criticized.
Pero sobre hechos reales.
But on the basis of facts.
No sobre ficciones.
Not on the basis of fiction.
Que para ficción ya es demasiado.
There's too much fiction going on already.
Y es el momento de ver las cosas como realidades históricas y concretas.
We should see things as a historical and concrete reality.
Hay un hecho importante.
We have an important fact here.
Nosotros existimos y la revolución existe.
We exist, the revolution exists.
Y este hecho hay que aceptarlo.
This fact must be accepted.
Este es un hecho histórico irreversible.
This is an irreversible historical fact.
Y es bueno asumir que la historia la hacen los pueblos.
And it's good to assume that history is made by peoples.
Y no es una frase demagógica.
This is not demagogy.
Yo estoy seguro que cuando pase esta tempestad tan dura y tan dolorosa,
I am sure that when this tempest, which has been so painful and so tough, blows over,
yo creo que pasará pronto.
And I think it will blow over soon.
Las relaciones entre Estados Unidos y América Latina habrán cambiado sustancialmente.
The relationship between the United States and Latin America will have changed substantially.
Las heridas de esta guerra son muy fuertes, muy grandes, muy profundas.
The wounds created by this war are very big, very deep, very profound.
Todavía están abiertas y sangran.
They are still open and bleeding.
Esperemos que el día de mañana cicatricen.
We hope that scars will be created tomorrow.
Y que podamos coexistir y convivir pacíficamente, amistosamente.
And that we may coexist and live together peacefully in a friendly fashion.
Aceptándonos los unos a los otros.
And accept each other.
Porque nuestros adversarios nos piden que nosotros aceptemos todo.
Because our adversaries demand that we accept everything.
Sin aceptar siquiera lo más elemental.
But they don't accept the most elementary thing.
Como es la situación inevitable de estar en una crisis económica y en una situación muy difícil.
Which is the inevitable situation of being in a very difficult situation.
Por el conjunto de factores que he mencionado.
Due to the factors that I have mentioned.
In your speech you've discussed human rights in theory, and I'd like to bring up an example about human rights in practice. During August, a report by the human rights group America's Watch, which I hear is a respectable journal similar to Amnesty International, cited increasing human rights abuses by Sandinista forces in complicity with the highest level of authority. In the village of Apostillo alone, 11 out of 200 residents were killed by your dictatorship's troops last year. Peasants like Matteo Lanzas were shot indiscriminately. Women like Carmenza Perez were raped. Santiago Rodriguez was lashed to a mule's tail and dragged to death. Evidently, they did not get the same treatment that your constitution prescribes. Given the atrocities your dictatorship commits, can you blame your people for joining the Nicaraguan freedom fighters? Guess this was in the September 9th Washington Post.
Esto apareció en el Washington Post el 9 de septiembre.
No sé de qué luchadores de la libertad se refieren.
I don't know to what freedom fighters you refer.
Y yo no quisiera sacar aquí una lista de los crímenes de esos sus paladines.
I would not like to bring up the list of crimes of those paladins.
Porque no creo que es con un inventario macabro.
Because it's not my role to put together a macabre inventory.
Que nosotros podemos afianzar o dar razón a nuestras argumentaciones.
This will not prove or sustain our arguments.
Yo lo que quiero reafirmar aquí es una cosa.
I would like to state here one thing.
Si ha habido violación a los derechos humanos, esta violación a los derechos humanos debe ser castigada de manera ejemplar.
If there has been any violation of human rights, this violation should be punished in an exemplary fashion.
Nosotros no tratamos de ocultar tras una cortina de humo cuando han habido casos de violación.
We do not try to throw up a smokescreen when cases of violations of human rights have emerged.
Yo no tengo la evidencia que lo que dice el Washington Post sea cierto.
I have no evidence that what the Washington Post says is true.
Pero está dentro del margen de lo posible que hayan habido 11 violaciones a los derechos humanos.
But it is within the realm of the possible that we could have had 11 violations of human rights.
En otros casos, ha habido casos específicos de violación de derechos humanos.
In other cases, there have been specific cases of violations of human rights.
Lo que no se ha mencionado jamás, sin embargo, en esos artículos.
However, those articles never mention.
Pero que sí lo mencionan otros informes de derechos humanos.
Although other human rights organizations do mention them.
Es que estos violadores de los derechos humanos han sido severamente castigados.
The fact that these people who violate human rights have been severely punished.
Que en Nicaragua existe una auditoría militar.
That there is in Nicaragua a military tribunal.
Para juzgar las violaciones de miembros del ejército o del Ministerio del Interior que pudiesen darse.
To judge violations that could be carried out by members of the armed forces or of the Ministry of Interior.
Yo no quiero ocultar tras una guerra cualquier violación que hubiese podido darse.
I do not want to hide behind the war situation any violation of human rights that may have occurred.
No es así como se defiende una revolución.
This is not the way to defend a revolution.
Y yo no voy a caer en el simplismo de sacar contra sus 11 200 o 400 violaciones de la contra.
And I don't want to fall into the simplistic argument of juxtaposing against your 11 the 200 or 400 violations in the hands of the contras.
Porque lo uno no justifica lo otro.
Because one crime does not justify the other.
Y nuestra obligación es preservar de la manera más categórica la integridad del ser humano.
And our obligation is to conserve as in the most categorical fashion possible the integrity of the human person.
Y en este espíritu han sido castigados varios militares en algún caso.
With this in mind, various people of the military forces have been punished.
Que en algún momento cometieron abusos.
When these people committed abuses.
No vamos a ocultar cuando el abuso exista.
We are not going to hide abuses when they exist.
Pero no podemos aceptar que se pretenda hacer de Nicaragua un sistema de abuso de los derechos humanos.
But we cannot accept the idea that Nicaragua is a system of abuses of human rights.
Cuando todos estos esfuerzos y otros más están encaminados a preservar en medio de la violencia que se ha generado desde hace una década.
Given that all of these efforts and many more have been put together to, within this war situation, preserve human rights.
Yo me preguntaría, y no para excusar cualquier injusticia o violación que en Nicaragua se hubiese cometido.
I would like to ask, and this is not an excuse for any violation of human rights or crimes that may have been committed in Nicaragua.
¿Se ha molestado alguno de ustedes que ha estado esta noche haciendo con todo derecho estas preguntas?
I would like to ask if any of you who have been here tonight, if you have bothered before asking these questions.
para ser suficientemente justo y equitativo en la defensa de un principio universal.
In order to be fair and truthful in defense of a universal principle.
La violación de derechos humanos en otros países en donde sí podría pensarse que ha habido una acción sistemática.
Whether you have considered the violation of human rights in other countries where you really could believe that there's systematic violation of human rights.
Sure.
¿Se ha pensado alguna vez? Permítame terminar, ¿no?
Have you ever considered, excuse me,
la situación de los derechos humanos en tiempos de guerra?
The situation of human rights when there is a war going on.
Y lo difícil que es a veces, a pesar de la voluntad de las autoridades supremas de un país.
And how difficult it is at times, despite the will of the authorities in a country.
Evitar las consecuencias y la lógica de la violencia.
To avoid the consequences and the logic of violence.
Yes, but in this case I'm talking about the arbitrary killing of civilians.
Sí, pero en este caso me estoy refiriendo a la matanza arbitraria de civiles.
No la conozco, no estoy informado de esa matanza arbitraria de civiles, pero si ocurrió, mire, si ocurrió y se prueba esto, esta gente tendrá que ser castigada de la manera más rigurosa y ejemplar que sea posible.
But if it did take place, then the people who carried this out should be punished in the most exemplary and rigorous fashion possible.
Are you implying that there's not an effective chain of command within your military forces?
O sea, ¿te implica que no hay una cadena de mando eficaz dentro de las fuerzas armadas?
No, mire, no me haga responsable de decir lo que no he dicho.
No, you shouldn't really make me responsible for saying something that I haven't said.
Es decir, tampoco se trata del juego del gato y el ratón, ¿no?
No, but you're implying that.
It's not a cat and mouse.
You're saying that.
Permítame responderle.
Let me answer.
Okay.
When we finish this exchange, I'd like each person to ask one question, one follow-up, and then allow other people to ask questions.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Mr. Ambassador, it was reported in Time magazine several weeks ago that over 500,000 Nicaraguans, almost 20% of the population, have deserted their country since 1979. The Wall Street Journal recently reported that the immigration rate to the United States has quadrupled in the past few months. Meanwhile, the Contras, who have often been blamed for disrupting the Nicaraguan economy and the family life and causing such out-migrations, have been largely driven from the country, and their influence in Nicaragua has greatly diminished. If consolidated Sandinista rule, which Nicaragua, I contend, now has, will be so beneficial to the people of Nicaragua, why do masses of Nicaraguans continue to leave the country now in accelerating rates?
Sí. Sería interesante ver. O sea, el régimen sandinista, como usted le llama, sí se va a consolidar. Está consolidado.
The Sandinista regime, as you call it, will consolidate, is consolidated.
Yo revertiría la pregunta.
I would like to pose a question in another way.
¿Por qué se consolida un régimen en una situación tan difícil?
How is it that a regime becomes consolidated in such a difficult situation?
No hay régimen en el mundo.
There is no regime in this world.
Por fuerte que sea.
No matter how powerful.
Su estructura militar.
It may be in a military structure.
Que pueda consolidarse si no lo quiere.
That can become consolidated unless that this is desired.
¿Por qué se consolida un régimen en el que hay 250,000 personas sobre las armas?
How do you consolidate a regimen in which we have 250,000 people in the armed forces?
Armas que tiene el pueblo.
Or who are armed, the people are armed.
Habría que preguntarse ¿Cuántos países de América Latina?
You'd have to ask yourself, how many Latin American countries
podrían poner 200,000 fusiles en manos del pueblo?
Could give 250,000 guns to the people.
Claro, ojalá no fuesen fusiles, sino arado lo que tenga el pueblo.
Well, I would prefer that they had plowshares rather than guns.
Lo que pasa es que una guerra no se defiende con arados, sino con fusiles.
But the fact is, you do not fight a war with plowshares, you fight it with guns.
Pero el hecho es ilustrativo.
But this is a good point to illustrate.
Y yo me valgo de su pregunta para darle en esta forma otra pregunta que es una respuesta.
And I would like to use your question to ask another question in response.
Sería más fácil para estas 250,000 personas voltear los cañones de los fusiles.
It would probably be easier for these 250,000 persons to turn their guns
y disparar contra el poder constituido en Nicaragua.
On the government and fire against the constitutional power of Nicaragua.
Sin embargo, la gente no solo huye del país, como usted dice, sino que muere por el país.
But the people do not only run away from the country, as you say, they also die for their country.
Y este es un hecho cierto.
And this is a fact.
Y nadie muere por gusto.
And nobody dies for the fun of it.
La situación, yo podría respondérsela, bueno, pues hay una situación económica.
I could answer the question, well, there's a very serious economic situation.
De esta gente, no todos van por razones ideológicas.
Not all of these people leave for ideological reasons.
Yo diría que los que han salido por razones ideológicas en estos últimos tiempos es una minoría completa.
I would say that the number of people who leave for ideological reasons are a very small minority.
La gente sale porque hay una situación económica muy difícil.
The people leave because there's a very difficult economic situation.
Porque hay 10 años de sacrificios.
And because they've been suffering and for 10 years.
Pero ya va siendo hora de buscar no solo los efectos de los problemas, sino sus causas también.
But this is time not only to look for the effects of problems, but also the cause of these problems.
Y entender que si esta revolución se ha mantenido durante 7 años.
And to understand that if this revolution has been in place for 7 years,
agredida por una fuerza que sabemos por quién es armada, dirigida y financiada,
attacked by forces whom we know full well who is behind them financially and providing arms,
no es porque no tenga un apoyo popular.
It hasn't been able to remain in power through lack of popular support.
Ciertamente Nicaragua no es un paraíso.
Of course, Nicaragua is not a paradise.
Ningún país en guerra es un paraíso.
No country that is going through a war is a paradise.
Pero lo sorprendente es por qué hay 250,000 personas defendiendo un país con la convicción con que lo hace.
But what is surprising is why are there 250,000 people defending the country with the conviction that they show?
This should be the last question.
Can I
A number of us have been following the case that the Christic Institute has been bringing against a group called the Secret Team, Richard Secord, Albert Hakim, and all his buddies, showing evidence that the CIA has been involved in drug running, among other things, in support of the Contras, and using that La Penca bombing as the base of their case, as the beginning point. Do you know if the Nicaraguan government has any evidence of drug running on either the part of the Contras or the CIA?
Creo que el gobierno ha dado ya algunas declaraciones sobre este asunto, ¿no?
I think the government has already made a number of statements about this affair.
De todas formas, yo en este momento no tengo pruebas concretas para hacer una afirmación desde esta tribuna.
In any case, at this moment, I don't have any proofs to make any sort of final statement.
Pero yo diría que no hace falta comprobar con documentos que hay un tráfico de drogas para apoyar a una contrarrevolución.
But I don't think you need the support of documents to state that there has been a drug traffic to favor a revolution.
Para que este hecho sea censurable.
This is a lamentable state of affairs.
Yo creo que 7 años de guerra contra un pueblo con o sin tráfico de droga, es ya de por sí lo suficientemente cruel e injusto para que lo sea.
7 years of war against a country with or without drug traffic is already sufficiently unfair.
A un pueblo contra el cual se ha lanzado todo.
This is a country that has received the brunt of everything.
Y no es fácil sostenerse 7 años luchando contra quien sabemos.
And it's not very easy to maintain a war for 7 years against we know whom.
Y son muy pocos los pueblos en el mundo entero, en el orbe entero, que puedan soportarlo.
And there are very few countries in the world, in the whole world, which would be able to sustain this.
Si no es con una convicción profunda.
Unless they were profoundly convinced.
De que lo que hacemos.
That what we do.
Más allá de cualquier limitación, imperfección o error.
Beyond our limitations, our imperfections, or our mistakes.
Los cuales sí los hemos cometido.
Which of course we have committed.
Constituye para nosotros el esfuerzo histórico más extraordinario en toda la historia de Nicaragua desde su independencia de España.
This constitutes for us the most important historical effort of Nicaragua in all of its history since it gained its independence from Spain.
Como es la última pregunta, yo quiero agradecerle a usted y a
todos. I would like to thank you and everybody.
A usted y a todos, inclusive a los que han sido muy duros en su, no digo en sus preguntas, porque no fueron preguntas, sino afirmaciones.
I would like to thank you, even those of you who posed difficult questions, or rather tough statements, because they were statements rather than questions.
No fueron interrogantes, sino acusaciones.
These were not questions, they were accusations.
Pero no importa.
But it doesn't matter.
Para eso estamos.
That's why we're here.
Y estaremos dispuestos a envolver nuevamente si las autoridades de este centro así lo consideran conveniente.
And I would be very willing to come back if the authorities of this place were to deem it desirable.
Para seguir discutiendo con ustedes.
In order to continue discussing with you.
Sin importar cualquiera que sea el tipo de pregunta o de afirmación.
Whatever statements
que ustedes hagan.
That you may pose.
Hablamos de libertad y de democracia.
We talk about freedom, we talk about democracy.
Y nos gusta practicarla también con ustedes en esta sala.
And we like to practice it also with you in this hall.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much.